Ding and Chun Meng.
Perfect game. Fang Lili to serve.
Check that. But either way, it's Lily Zhang to start this best of seven match with the serve. Love to all. Quite an interesting serve. Looked relatively empty. Comes just off the back of the table there. Jamming up Miyu Hirano near the back edge. Over the table, Miyu Hirano taking advantage of a ball with just a little bit of height on it. Forehand flick for the point. Lee Jong quick in the rally, recovers. Now in terms of the exchange here, Miyu Hirano is the favorite to win this match, but it could go either way. I've seen Lily Zhang pull off some very impressive wins against women in the top 20 in the world. Victoria Pavlovich, Georgina Poda, a few of the names Lily Zhang has taken down on the big stage nonetheless. Good placement here, deep and wide to the backhand. Hirano with her second point. Good placement here to the middle. Miyu Hirano getting a late reaction, forcing Lily Zhang to make a decision. Lily chooses to turn for the forehand. It's a very tough ball. I mean, the placement has to be so specific. Not just side to side, but the depth on the table will not allow Lily Zhang time. If that's deeper on the table, she'll play the backhand. If it's more shallow on the table, she'll have the forehand with more comfort. There's the counter. Gets the racket head up and out of the first towel break. Continues to hang on to the lead, get the lead back. Spin shot on the parallel here. The Hurricane ties it right back up. On top of every shot in this rally. From the start, she knew what she was doing. Fast, long serve, one to the corner and deep the other way. 51 kilometers per hour for the last shot. Less spin on it, as you could see. Still a relatively high number, but compared to the other shots we see in the fast, or more the spinny rallies, a little bit more for speed than spin from Lily Zhang. Dribbler off the top of the net to help out. A bit of fortune for Zhang. Talked about collegiate play. Lily Zhang not only a four-time U.S. national champion, also a collegiate national champion, NCTTA national champion. Backed off the table here, deep to the corner. Miyu Hirano making her way in. Second towel break, just 2 points between them. Lily Zhang doing a good job to keep the ball on the table there on that backhand, but again, a little bit shallow, allows Miyu Hirano a little bit more control of the angle. A little bit higher percentage shot to come down on.
Ooh. 7-6.
A gift for Miyu Hirano. Just thinking about the service game, Lily taking the first point outright on service. Similar motion, something a little bit like a shovel serve. Looking to be a bit empty on the parallel, but a fast serve nonetheless. Forehand flick kill does it. Lily Zhang hangs on to the lead after being up 7-4. Now 8-6. Right at the baseline, that forehand flick. Long kick serve, jumps past the racket, an outright ace against Lily Zhang. Brings Miu Hirano within 1 point. Sizing up the opponent here, trying to get a sense of what mood she's in, what type of receive she might be planning. Good placement here again from Hirano, deep to the corner, bringing Lily Zhang out a bit, forcing her to have to backpedal to get deep back to the backhand. Tied up at 8 points apiece. Important serves here for Lily Zhang to regain control. The backhand does it. Deep on the table. Now, Lily Zhang's still for me. We haven't seen her backhand come out to play the way I'm used to seeing it. I think 1 point in the entire first game has had the Lily Zhang backhand that stings the opponent and causes a lot of upsets. Two parallel backhands and the topspin to help out. Lily Zhang now with 2 game points. Converts both of her serves, 10 shots in the last rally, a quicker exchange, but again, the way Miu Hirano's been playing, I'd say the last 6 months or so on the World Tour, she's not playing to get into the rally, she's playing to finish the point. See how she does with the serves here. Again, 2 game points for US's Lily Zhang. Perfectly played shot against heavy topspin. Lily Zhang with a little head shake there, not happy with the way she handled that serve. Felt like she could have caused a bit more threat. And the hurricane twisting, taking everything in her path. Game point, Zhang. Spun perfectly deep on the table. Miu Hirano saves both game points right at the baseline there. A very difficult ball to handle. Nerves of steel in game one, and it's tied up deuce. The empty serve placed middle into the body. Lily Zhang handles well to cover with the backhand. Sets up the point to keep herself in position. And game point once again, third game point for USA's Lily Zhang. The backhand does it. Lily Zhang 12-10 over the Hurricane. Quite a strong performance here for world rank number 49. A long way to go. It's a best of seven. We'll see what happens, but on the backhand flick inside the table, she takes game number one. Stick around, game number two, coming up right after this.
Second game, Hirano Miu to serve, love ball.
Players back to the table for game number two. Miu Hirano, the Hurricane, at the top of the screen, starting with the serve down 0-1 in games. Lily adjusts to the serve that comes in, that kick serve, shovel the top and side spin. But Miu Hirano drives it deep to the backhand corner in the end for the point. Beautiful counter. Again with a strong receive coming in, the short stroke forehand. Miu Hirano right there for one. And another one even shorter to the short side, just passed. Not even a racket up on that side. Fast long serve, but Miu Hirano holds her ground patiently. Very responsible receive. Clever idea, Lily Zhang knew. Miu Hirano was waiting for that cross-court forehand flick, so tried to go long with the push the other way. And the soft spin to the middle, a little shallow. Miu Hirano doing a good job of moving in. It's not as easy as she made it look to play that ball, let alone an inside-out forehand with it. See the wrist bend in just a little bit for that extra spin on the ball. 5,200 RPMs on that shot. First point for Lily Zhang. First towel break. Both players will take advantage of that. Feels like just yesterday I was watching Lily Zhang when she was 9 years old competing in the U.S. Hopping around at the back of the table with short strokes. Choing and fighting, climbing her way to the top, or just near. Right now, Wu Yue in front, number one for the U.S. women.
Fight.
Wu Yue actually still in the tournament. Exciting match ahead today after showing some very impressive form yesterday. Came out top of her group. Lily Zhang came out number two in the group. Hence a tough battle here against, I'd imagine, the fourth seed. And the fast backhand to backhand exchange. It's Lily Zhang's first point. Three in a row from down 0-5. Good touch. Lily Zhang softens up the hands. You got to loosen up the grip on the racket for this, like Lily Zhang does, to leave it softly at the back of the table. Again, from baseline, it's tough to keep it just behind the net. Lily Zhang did, well, just enough to do the job. Miu Hirano backing Lily into the corner again, trying to get her behind the table a little bit. Side and top spin on the pendulum. Again, subtle contact. Not a lot of follow through from Lily Zhang. As one of many players from the United States who's playing overseas right now, Lily Zhang has gained a lot of experience, I'd imagine. More deception on the serve. How to be in position for the rallies when they get long.
Tight.
The backhand coming out from the deep backhand corner. And Lily Zhang from down 0-5 wins 6 out of the next 7 points. I mean, it was easy, even from where I'm sitting, to think, well, surely Miu Hirano, the stronger player, just needed a little wake-up call in game number one, but she's unleashed the beast. 5-0, not letting Lily Zhang get a single point. But Lily Zhang saying, no, I'm still here and I'm ready. One game isn't enough, let's see. A good backhand flick from the forehand side, coming in over the table, taking the risk, but putting the pressure on. And a timeout on Miu Hirano's side. This is a very interesting time for a timeout. 5-0 up. Not 5-3, not 5-4. Not 5-5, if that's what it was, or 6-6, but down 6-7. Obviously, the coach knows Miu Hirano quite well. And I have to credit him for his knowledge, of course. So, he must be thinking right now, with a little conversation, a thing or two will change out here, and Miu Hirano can take this game. All she has to do is win a little bit more than Lily Zhang for the rest of game number two, no problem. Again, textbook perfect forehand there. But Lily Zhang finding the elbow on the other side, getting Miu Hirano to take that backhand from the middle here. A look at the forehand. Just amazing, the technique of the pros. And occasionally you'll see pros with unusual technique. Interestingly enough, on the men's side of the game, one of the most celebrated legends of this sport, Timo Boll, with a bit unconventional technique, but it's been effective all the way through what? He's 38 years old now and still coming out and beating Chinese players, causing threats to the top in the world, taking titles where he can. 2018. Quite impressive year for Timo, 27 as well. But Lily Zhang up by one right now. Massive comeback here out of Miu Hirano's timeout. Let's see. And the half-long serve got a lukewarm receive. I thought it was a good serve from Hirano. Just a little bit wide on the third ball attack. And Lily Zhang continues her streak. Up 8-6 with the serves on her side. A little off the top of the net, but a good turn from the middle to play the forehand. Well placed deep to the wide corner. Miu Hirano reading the relatively empty serve. Pretty big point there to come back with the serves on your side, down just 2 points rather than being down 4 game points at 6-10. So now 7-9 for the Hurricane. A lot of rotation on this serve, sits up and inside the table just a little bit. Hirano within 1 point. What's it gonna be? Double serve with the topspin, but Lily Zhang reads it and plays it deep to the corner with the forehand flick once again. 2 game points, just like in game number one. Game number one, Miu Hirano won both of the next points to send it to deuce before Lily Zhang would win 12-10. Lily Zhang looking for no extra points needed in this game. Deeper pendulum serve, middle of the table, and 11-8, Lily Zhang, world ranked number 49, up 2-0 against the Hurricane Miu Hirano. Stay right here to see what happens. The plot only thickens from here on out. Game three, coming up right after this. Back for game number three, Lily Zhang up 2-0 at the top of the screen. USA's four-time national champion, Lily Zhang. Good cover from the middle, but showing the fast footwork as she lunges out in case that ball comes down to the deep forehand corner. Got a quality opening backhand here from the Hurricane to fend off any chance for a third ball, or at least put a lot of pressure on Lily Zhang to be more responsive rather than creating the big opening. Tight shovel serve and a beautiful backhand to follow right at the baseline. Hirano spinning it past Lily Zhang. Lily Zhang. That is too perfect. I thought the receive from Lily Zhang surely would be enough, or at least enough to put pressure on Miu Hirano, but she was there. And not just there, plays it for a parallel forehand down the line, 57 kilometers per hour, just under 5 grand in terms of the rotation, the RPM. Little break off the net here for Lily Zhang. Now, score-wise, it just reminds you, or I'd like to remind you, rather, that in game number 2, Miu Hirano was leading 5-0. Lily Zhang came back to be up 9-6. 9 out of the next 10 points. Well, I think of Lily Zhang's backhand as probably her strongest suit. Quick off the bounce. Again, she's quick in her footwork, something she's been working on. I remember when she was still in college at Berkeley and competing at the World Championships, beating some world-class players, thinking how strong could she be if she was focused full-time like a lot of the rest of the world, the top players in the world. And now she is. She's a full-time professional with Miu Hirano. 5-2 up, second serve here on her racket. Floats it up for one shot. Fans are going to love that here. Well, now, a tough point. But as deep as that lob was, she kept Miu Hirano out of threat. Watch where this ball comes down, right near the sideline, deep on the backhand. And with the step round, a swatting backhand punch from behind the table, enough to finish the point. But Miu Hirano near the table, right back to answer with a quick backhand. Can't flick much harder than that. Miu Hirano over the table, showing her superiority here in game 3. So 4 points out in front. Again, we've seen bigger comebacks. Last 2 matches, actually. Good shallow spin shot here. Lily keeping it low to the net. Very short stroke. You could see the racket head from Lily Zhang coming into that ball. Didn't have to dip too low to start. That means the surprise factor is going to be higher. Less time for Miu Hirano to really respond or set up her plan. But as quick as can be, the Hurricane off the bounce goes cross court for the winner. 8-4 at the second towel break. 3 points away from getting her first game on the scoreboard. Again, pick your player. If you're watching Lily Zhang in that rally, you think that backhand's strong enough to set her up well. But Miu Hirano anticipates well, holds her ground, and moves to the backhand corner to counter back. Serve close enough to the back of the table that it doesn't allow a full free stroke. Lily Zhang edging closer, still 3 points down. High arcing spin shot. Lily Zhang backs up a little bit, moving to the forehand side, anticipating the counter from Miu Hirano. Causes a little bit of hesitation on the Hurricane side. Still 2 points in front. Surely the Hurricane will pull through here. And right back down the line, a quick forehand for a 3-point lead. This is the turning point for Miu Hirano. Over 6,000 RPM on that last ball on a parallel. You need that spin to make sure the ball comes down to the short side. Corner to corner, smart play. Good placement. It is 4 game points for Miu Hirano in game number 3. Tight serve, spin shot goes long. Lily's placement on that pendulum serve has been quite effective, forehand side. Three game points left for the Hurricane. Top of the net, a little fortune here. Seemed like it caught the edge too. I'm not sure if it was both. If it is, double happiness. Not the ball sponsor for this tournament. Nope, just net, deep on the table. They are playing with the Nitaku Premiums, which we've seen from time to time on the World Champions, World Championships or different tournaments. Shovel serve does it, 11-8. Miu Hirano gets her first game on the scoreboard. Come back in action, we shall see. The Hurricane down 1-2 against USA's Lily Zhang. We'll be back for game number 4 right after this.
The following match of table 2 is Hu Yue representing USA playing against Pokonova Song representing Austria. Umpire for table 2, Yang Yini from China. Assistant umpire for table 2, Tai Yong from China.
Player! Zhang and Miu, clear the timeout. Assist time. Don't delay.
Back for game number 4. Both players being warned not to delay, that when time is up, means come back to the table. So Miu Hirano down 1-2, winning last game. A bit of momentum on her side. The serve as well. Lily Zhang leading on the receive. Soft and spinning. Miu Hirano takes the ball a little bit earlier, wide for the point. Relatively deep on the table, just a little bit inside the baseline there. Hirano with the surprise placement. Instead of going out to the wide forehand that was open, hits it behind Lily Zhang's body's momentum. Counter backhand from deep in the corner. Zhang with her first point on the scoreboard now. Good step behind the table, preparing for the opening spin shot of Miu Hirano. So a solid start once again. Miu Hirano in the lead.
3-1.
3-1. Fast counter rally here. Miu Hirano getting the crowd behind her with the beauty on this shot. Turns. Watch her play the forehand after the rally extends. Backhand to backhand. One forehand. Little backswing in the open corner. Just races through. Well countered here. Heavy spin. That grunt from Miu Hirano. But Lily Zhang closes the racket to counter back. First towel break, 2 points between them. We've seen a lot bigger spreads, a lot bigger leads from both players. Again, 5-0 in game 2. Before it was 9-6 for Lily Zhang.
Three, four.
Pendulum serve has been quite effective. Coach Thung in the corner, Jeffrey Thung. Fast long serve, well received, but again, Lily Zhang ready for the ball to come back quickly, extends to the wide forehand and plays it out to the wide wing. Cross court for the winner. 2 points recovered on her serve, back to Miu Hirano for the serves. And the spinny ball inside the table, Miu Hirano playing an excellent counterattack to the backhand. Testing Lily Zhang with the first serve, forcing her to play a backhand from behind the body. A different backhand here. From more central on the table, Lily Zhang spins it parallel, gets herself in position for the point, tied back up again. Deep to the corner as can be, forces Lily Zhang to be a little bit late getting to that wide position. Hirano up by one on the receive. Empty serve and it's ripped, but it's countered right back, a parallel backhand. Tying up the score here, creating an opening on the forehand side with that dangling wide serve. Relatively fast, relatively spinny, but still not the fastest shots we've seen today, nor will we see. I think we will see faster than anything we've seen yet in the matches to come. Possibly even later on this match.
Help. 7-6.
Zhang expressing a bit of frustration here again. After being up 2-0, on paper, a very unlikely win for Lily Zhang. But very much in this match, still in the lead game-wise, but down 1 in points here. The passive receive attempted to be pushed long here. It's 2 points in the lead, the Hurricane. They've been back and forth throughout this game. Lily Zhang was chasing in the early parts. Almost recovers the net ball. Maybe Miu Hirano just forgetting that it clipped the net on the way over. Could see it change its trajectory there. With the speed of the ball coming in, something so faint, so little still. It's actually a fairly significant net to break the rhythm. Good move by Lily, and even with a little bit of time, just barely any time to set up for this backhand, is able to spray it out wide. Top side spin. Here's the first chasing shot. Moves back and just tucks the wrist to snap through that ball. Brings her within two, but she's on the receive now. Miu Hirano just 2 points away from another game on the scoreboard. But a solid receive over the table. Miu Hirano has already used her timeout. I'll bet she wishes that she had one right now. 1 point in the lead, second serve here. Backhand so strong. Gets a passive receive and sets up at the back of the table. 2 game points for Miu Hirano. Third towel break. Lily Zhang has the serves back on her racket. Pendulum serve comes just off the table and cautiously at the back of the table spinning. The Hurricane takes game number 4. It's tied up at 2 games apiece. We'll see who takes the lead in game number 5 coming up right after this. Players back for game number five. A bit of momentum on the Hurricanes' side. Is Lily Zhang in the path of the Hurricane? She started off with a two-game lead. USA's Lily Zhang has fought tight battles in games three and four. But this is the pivot point to take control. But it's Miu Hirano who does just that with the opening backhand receive. Exchange we've seen yet between these two. Rocket backhand to backhand, and even a forehand turn there from the Hurricane. We know, as I'd say we know because we've seen Miu Hirano play so many points like this on the World Tour throughout the years. Perfect parallel shot here. But Lily Zhang, you don't get to see in televised matches quite as much. Continental matches, national championships in the U.S. She can play these fast rallies. On her Instagram, I've seen some of it with the Chinese national team training just as fast. A bit of juice on this one, inside out spin from Miu Hirano to bend that ball deep to the backhand corner. 75% of the first points going to the Hurricanes so far here in game five. Serve drifts a little long. Strong opening, but Lily Zhang, for probably about the fifth time so far in this match, has had that quick counter forehand after or in response to a strong opening from Miu Hirano. This one just too wide, well placed. The soft one that sets it up is Miu Hirano's touch shot just behind the net on the forehand. Lily Zhang only able to get there in time to play a soft shot over the table rather than a flick. That creates the opening for Miu Hirano. Fist clinched and look to kill. The eyes, the focus, again, it's so different when she's on the table as to when she's in warm-ups, or when she's stretching, or just in daily life, at breakfast, for example. Break off the net. Lily Zhang hanging in for some big points. U.S. fans in the corner here. Looked like Lily Zhang's dad. It's been a while since I've seen him. Wouldn't surprise me, though. I remember a math professor. This time, netting out. Miu Hirano getting that lead back to two. Another gift for Hirano. Trying to play bold here with the long serve. Surprise Hirano. It's a tough position to be in. We've seen it a lot on the World Tour and even this tournament. But your surprise has already been spent now. Would it be surprising to serve long again? Is it worth the risk? So shortens it up, goes for the pendulum serve. Again, service game. Lily Zhang, there's been a lot to the middle and the forehand to Miu Hirano. Look, that's something we've seen a bit of, but when the shovel serve comes out from Miu Hirano, it's almost exclusively middle and forehand. A little bit on the longer side of half long, but tight enough. Hirano with a 3-point lead now, looking to continue the streak that she started in game three. Soft but very spinny. Lily Zhang within two now with the second towel break. These are the ones that I'm very curious about, the rotations per minute, the slower, spinnier ones. Miu Hirano, no question about how she feels about that last ball. Quite surprised. The ball didn't go where she had planned. And a little bit of extra speed. Lily Zhang within 1 point. Again, Lily Zhang still has her timeout if she needs it. But this would be more the time for Miu Hirano to call if she had one, which she does not. Timeout has been spent. Strong opening receive. Miu Hirano taking advantage of a little height on the ball, not a lot, but a bold receive puts her back up by two. Taking a look at the draw here, the winner of this match is fighting for the winner of Austria's Sofia Polkanova and USA's Wu Yue. Clever receive with the bit of side spin on it. The brushing shot from Lily does not bother Miu Hirano. The winds are whirling. The spin's twisting out here as Hirano gets ever closer to a third game on the scoreboard. Second serve. Tight receive, Zhang right off the bounce within two. Outstanding rally again. It's Miu Hirano who prevails. Quick off the bounce with the forehand, and now three game points for the Hurricane. Backhand off the bounce to save a game point. Third towel break. This is where the scoring has stopped in the last two games for Lily Zhang. Both games 11-8 to Miu Hirano. Relatively close, but still enough wiggle room to feel the confidence on Miu Hirano's side. Deceived on the spin there. Lily Zhang trying for the push game to get it quick off the bounce, but Miu Hirano 11-8. Once again, third game in a row. The comeback is real, and she is one game away from moving on. Will Miu Hirano take it in the sixth, or will Lily Zhang send this to a deciding seventh? Game number six. Coming up, stay right here. Players back for game number six. Hurricane twisting, stretching it out. Three games in a row, a lot of momentum now. One more to go. Lily Zhang was up 2-0, looking to fight back, claw her way into the decider. Parallel backhand to survive a bit on the chase here. We've seen Lily Zhang make some impressive shots with very little backswing, even when she was on the move to get in position. Doesn't take too much for her. to get in control of the point. Right at the baseline into the body, anticipates the flick and gets back to the wide backhand, forehand corner rather. But the placement there, couldn't get much better than that to jam up Miu Hirano. Still protect her positioning. Had the ball come back into play, Lily Zhang would have been perfectly in position. Kill shot over the table, forehand flick with some massive power from Lily Zhang. Solid start, not a point dropped so far from USA's Lily Zhang. Parallel backhand to continue the streak. Again, the last three games have been relatively close. Not quite the 12-10 we saw in game one, but enough to know that Lily Zhang we cannot count out. But Miu Hirano we've seen come back. Serves on her side down 0-4. Made the tough shot in the rally, the parallel backhand, or the parallel shot rather, from Miu Hirano. Watch the forehand, that was the shot before this. Lily Zhang opens it up but tries to play deep to the corner. On the scoreboard now with her first point. Ooh, the ball does not come over after the top of the net. 2 points now for Miu Hirano with the second towel break. Serves back with Lily Zhang. I think she's only had 2 service errors so far this match. But other than that, you saw her service placement in the last game. It appeared that she had moved it more middle and backhand of Miu Hirano. Pendulum serve occasionally to the forehand side. But again, primarily the middle of the table, bending into the forehand, or excuse me, bending into the body rather. Tight serve, a little bit less rotation here. Back up by 3, Lily Zhang. Imagine a point would go this long from the start of the setup with the speed of the Hurricane. Tries to go the other way. I think I might have pulled a back muscle just watching this. Lily Zhang doing the unthinkable out here with Miu Hirano playing almost every shot back on the table with precision. What a scar-powering point here. How can that not affect you mentally? Lily Zhang up now 7-2. And the flick goes long as well. This could go to the decider. Score-wise right now, it's definitely looking possible, quite imaginable. 6 points in the lead. Lily Zhang with the serves on her side as well. Counter goes a little bit long, but Lily Zhang is there. Acknowledges that she set up the point well, I think. That was a head nod of positivity as if to say, it's okay, you know what happened. Miu Hirano making her way back 1 point at a time though, slowly here in game 6. Soft strawberry countered from inside. Right near the table anyway, I guess just outside, but Lily Zhang takes the forehand from the back of the table. 5,500 RPM. Again, spin in table tennis is a game changer.
Light, 3-9.
A little bit it off the net, but a strong exchange here. Miu Hirano changes for the parallel ball. Both players turning for forehands from the middle. That was the one that clipped. The retrieving game still, I can't believe, I've watched Lily Zhang play quite a lot. I haven't seen her lob as much and as well as she has here today, but Hirano within four. If she scores one more point, I wouldn't be surprised to see a timeout from USA's corner. Lily Zhang's corner, still 4 points in the lead, looking to take advantage of the serve here. It's been a while since a long serve has been effective for Lily Zhang. Relatively empty serve, pushed back long. Again, the underspin, it is now 5 game points. Just thinking that serve where she comes straight at the back of the ball. 1 point away from the decider. Backhand to backhand, Lily Zhang takes game number 6, and we are going to the decider, the Hurricane versus USA's Lily Zhang. Grab your snacks, grab your drinks, and tell your friends what they need to be watching right now. Final game in the round of 16 between Lily Zhang and the Hurricane. Game 7 coming right up.
Final game, Zhangli Fuzhou, love all.
Here we are, game number 7, the last game in this match. Lily Zhang with some momentum and the serve on her side. And she takes the first point in position for the strong 2 topspins. The footwork of Lily Zhang to recover some of these wide angles. Many women in the world, some of the top players have had trouble against Miu Hirano's speed and placement. Catches the edge of the racket. Nice improvisation here. An impromptu receive after a little hesitation. Miu Hirano goes passive, but leaves it right near the back edge, the corner of the table to take the point. Heavy spin, turning from the backhand side to use the forehand. Lily Zhang up 2-1 here. A long way to go. The level of focus required right now to play every point at the level that Lily Zhang has to compete with world number 9, Miu Hirano, is just unthinkable. Parallel backhand to take a 3-1 lead off the bounce. She's testing Miu Hirano. Looking a bit scattered after some of these rallies. Miu Hirano left with a bitter taste. Lily Zhang with the serves on her side now up 3-1. Let service.
3-1.
That empty serve once again. Lily Zhang finds herself in the middle of the table with a backhand as strong as Lily Zhang. You can understand why she's positioned where she is. And that makes it tough for Miu Hirano to find the wide angles. Yeah. Quick backhand off the bounce. They will switch sides as Lily Zhang has 5 points now to make sure that it's an even spread. A strong start for USA's Lily Zhang. We've seen some strong performances from her over the years. Again, on the totem pole for table tennis, there's no question where USA is compared to Japan right now. Japan way out in front of the rest of the world, other than China, a distant second to China. But this would be incredible, a long way to go still. Behind the table a little bit, the defensive play from Lily Zhang just long. Good pressure from Hirano to get her second point on the scoreboard. Again, the sport is quite popular in Japan, so I imagine a bunch of Japanese fans watching nervously right now for the Hurricane. As quick as can be, has Lily Zhang sent to the floor, corner to corner. Hirano turns up the pace and really hits the placement here. Fast to the backhand corner and quick forehand the other way, 72 kilometers per hour. I think that's the highest I've seen today. Not to mention that it was coming off of the shot just before. Hirano focused as can be here. Comeback in the making, just down two. She's within one, timeout here. Yep, absolutely. From 5-1 up, 3 points in a row for the Hurricane. Lily Zhang getting close, will not make the history books. It rarely does. It's taking the match that makes the difference, pulling off the upset. What will it take? Now, I don't imagine that Lily Zhang and Jeffrey Zung have a ton of experience working together, but here, Jeffrey Zung has been the coach for the U.S. women. Again, back and forth, I think, between Sichuan and Maryland in the United States. Jeffrey Zung, a former provincial player. Here in Sichuan province team. So one thing that's worked quite well for Lily Zhang is the floating pushes, serves with light underspin to the middle of the table. But variation is so important because one thing that Miu Hirano has a lot of is experience at the highest level. And what that means is she can adapt to a game. If she sees the same thing even a few times, she knows how to adjust and take advantage. Well, let's see. Still 1 point in the lead here. Lily Zhang. Ah, pendulum serve. Right into the elbow, and deceptive. Couldn't see the contact. You have to imagine there was either less topspin on it, more side spin, or even underspin for that matter, for the ball to come back into the net. But a big point out of the timeout. Miu Hirano now down two. And well read on the serve receive here. Lily Zhang with the fan club in the crowd. Double serve, mostly side, a little top. 3 point lead. Miu Hirano once again looking down at the equipment. That feeling of I've done everything right. Oh, and a break here. Lily Zhang, well now. I don't even remember where the net came down. Was it Lily Zhang's break? I think she recovered the net ball. And Miu Hirano trying to go inside out, but the speed of Lily Zhang's footwork and the wingspan adds extra pressure to go wide. Freeze frame of Lily Zhang, and maybe not her new Facebook profile picture, but a moment of apology, acknowledging a bit of fortune there. 4 points in the lead at the second towel break, 3 points away from what would be the biggest story this tournament. Hirano with the heavy spin receive. No timeouts left. Remember that. Both players now left with experience, left with nerve, grit. And a 3-point lead for Lily Zhang. ripping backhand, and she's 2 points away, extending back to the 4-point lead. Now remember, Miu Hirano is fighting for more than just a title and more than just points here. A former World Cup winner, she is a strong candidate for one of two spots in the singles in Tokyo 2020. Forehand flick, and Lily Zhang over the table has set up 5 match points for an upset that will be massive news throughout the US, and I have to imagine in Japan as well, but in the table tennis world, this is one noteworthy upset on the brink of happening. Incredible rally, and she does it backhand to backhand. USA's Lily Zhang pulls off the upset of the tournament so far. 12 shots at lightning speed. What a performance. 23-year-old Lily Zhang of the United States of America has taken down former Women's World Cup winner, the Hurricane Miu Hirano of Japan. 4th seed knocked out in the round of 16. Print the papers now. The press will be all over this one. Lily Zhang has a long road ahead, but she has to enjoy the fruits of her labor out here today. This match was absolutely breathtaking. So Miu Hirano, a tough day, but congratulations, Lily Zhang. What a performance.